Okay, time for some more of the Alone in the Dark. This is where I was left off last time, and now my destination is now the dining room. That's right, I keep forgetting that, I'll be playing this game more than once. So anyways, I'm making my way to the dining room now. Because I solved the extremely annoying, telescope puzzle the last time. Unless I have to do it again. God have mercy of my soul if that's the case. Thankfully, I don't. Thankfully, I do not have to do the telescope again. God, that was such a... that was annoying. Oh, sorry, I forgot there's more than one entrance to the dining room. So, which means I have to... which means I've got all... I got a lot of exploring to do. Probably the most efficient route is to go through stair hall, up the stairs. Yeah. Okay, where am I supposed to go then? Like, how am I supposed to get to the dining hall? Oh, wait, dining room's right here. Duh. There we go. Let's have a look around. Oh, right. aggressive breath. Oh, that's more like it. On the common place of evil. That's it. That's all there is. Well, there's gotta be more to this than just a piece of paper. Well, that was, fruitless. Didn't really learn a whole lot. And didn't it give me exactly what I wanted? So with that done, what next? Show that the gable open in the dining room. So what am I looking for in here exactly? Gate I'm going to be opening in here. Oh. Ask a silly question, give myself a silly answer. Chapter 3.
So is the convent of Garaway. I'm a man Yermi has never met, and we are in a place that he has never been.
Okay. So are you here to guide me?
purpose than you. I simply know. I will happily help you, of course, if I may.
If you are already somehow part of Jeremy, why did he want to come? Isn't he sort of here already?
Jeremy wanted to come here because it's a representation of his mind at peace. When Dr. Gray asks him to find his focus during his sessions, this far-flung convent is what Jeremy imagines. He is under the impression that if he could physically come here, he would reach a perfect equanimity. A spiritual apotheosis.
You don't think it would work?
Jeremy subconsciously knows it's just wishful thinking. He can't come here. Despite the pathways opened by the dark man between their setup and Jeremy's psyche, it's simply not possible.
But I'm here.
Indeed. It's a shame it's just another place for you. Otherwise, you could have become a Buddha.
Always a bridesmaid, never a blushing bride. Alright.
Yes, I suppose so. You'll have to chase enlightenment elsewhere.
So what's the next best thing? What can I do here?
You should seek out the convent library and try to find the truth about Jeremy's relationship with the Dark Man. It's the sort of knowledge he represses and is unable to reflect on.
Well, tell me how to break the pattern.
Perhaps. At least you'll have something to confront Jeremy.
Wait, why can't you just tell me?
I don't know such things. You'd be better off consulting the text of Dr. Fry, if you want such answers.
Thanks, I hate tricks.
There is another thing you should know about the library. He is here as well. The Dark Man has been working his way through the text for a long, long time.
He's here? How am I supposed to get past him?
Be careful, Detective.
Oh, jeez. Just perfect.
Hubertus. Uh-oh. To do? Excuse you, but wow. I gotta keep asking. Stop asking such silly questions. I'm asked evil. Beast of Burden. Bull worship is common throughout history. For Christians, this can be seen in Exodus when the Israelites turned to worship a golden calf in Moses' absence. This passage shows the people falling back to the worship witnessed in Egypt known as the Hapus Bull. Another famous example is the Minoans on the island of Crete. Their worship of the bull gave rise to the myth of the Minotaurus, the half-man, half-bull monster that reigned the labyrinth. But for this particular case, I think I should tell you about the deity Astarte that brought the Taurus constellation to life to attack Gilgamesh. Even for a mythical hero, this celestial bull would prove difficult to defeat, only by distracting the bull with a golden sail, with Gilgamesh able to pierce an eye with a spear, which bled the bull to death. Interesting, to say the least. Alright. Yeah, that's more like it. So she's not gonna make it to the other, whatchamacallit. Get away from me, dude. Jeez, now what? And I don't think you can defeat him, so... must be the Dark Man. Because if it isn't, I'll be very surprised. Because I can't fit through there, despite the fact that it looks like I can. That elevator must be my way out.
Detective!
What? What?
You wonder if he made a promise, can't he simply stand by his words?
Look, I'm just trying to get Jeremy out of the bed so he'll come back with us.
It all fails. It's a sign of submission to the dark man. I saw it in the dream once.
Crescent City. New Orleans lies southwest of Derketo, along the Great Mississippi River. Its old town, the French Quarter, or the Ville Claire, is the home of the proud and often rich Creoles. Wrapped around this center, you will find a large and eclectic city full of people, including the most mundane dock workers, reckless gangsters, jazz-crazed flappers, and, of course, the mysterious voodoo people. At night, you can stand on the lakeside of Derketo and watch New Orleans glow like embers on the horizon. machine gun cartridge. Interesting. Typewriter ribbon. Steve Dorr's key. Christ almighty! Get off! Jeez! Jesus alive! Oh my god! So incredibly stupid. I gotta start a pretty good distance back. At least he's dead. That's all I care for. Or oh. I guess I don't have to start so far back after all. Whatever. Whatever. Job's done. That's all I care for. I should use the shotgun, but whatever. Oh, somebody's crawling around. There's someone there. Severed horn. Thousand young. Asleep with anesthesia mind, Jeremy filtered these words from Dirketto's gangrenous ground. Even their praises, in abundance to the black goat of the woods, hear us, mother, and take pity on us. Accept our sacrifice and judge our worth. Eshub Niggurath, Eshub Niggurath, the black goat of the woods with a thousand young. right? Do we have here? Thompson. Tommy gun. Nice. All right, I gotta find the combination to the safe. The next thing I gotta do. All his things. I'll read this. Our ship was raided while on dock. All of his things were recovered, but blood was shed. Several men were carried into the Mississippi River and drowned by the ones who live in the deep. All items have been signed and delivered. Now best keep the paper safe. What is left, later is right, and hell is back again. Huh? That's gotta be the most unusual, it would be nice to have some numbers. Gambling. What is left, later is right, hell is back again. What are they talking about? I don't get it. What is left, later is right. Hell's back again? What? I must be missing something here. Let's back into the sewers. I can't open the... Wait, could I open the door? Thought I could for a moment, but I guess I can't. Oh, well. So I know it goes left, right, left, but... doesn't make any sense. Something isn't right with the world. Doesn't say anything though. This just doesn't make any sense. I'm trying to look at the map here, and yet... Hold on, wrong zoom. There we go. I see M. I can assume that's a 3. And I see a 6 here. And there's a 4 right there. There's another 3. Could that be it? No. I'm looking at the map right now, and nothing is making sense. What am I missing here? I do not understand where I'm going with this. Wait. That looks like a 5, 4, 3, but these are just municipalities here. I doubt they have anything to do with the safe. I'm getting sick and tired of looking things up. Stuff. There's the manifest. Oh, Jesus. little worse for the wear, but I survived. Fog's not really clearing up, dude. In fact, it looks like it's getting worse. Here we go.
Where we are.
We didn't get to finish our last conversation, did we? You were about to tell me how to break the contract.
No. I'm gonna lose something. So many things.
But there is a way to break out of the deal.
Damn it, Jeremy. I'm gonna save you. Don't worry.
Okay, so it looks like we got another one of these Zodiac things. So it looks like we got Gemini. Hold on. Virgo and Pisces. Gemini, Virgo, Pisces. Hold on, I don't want to do the talisman just yet. So Gemini is... So that's 2, 5, 8, huh? I need the key. Inside the sarcophagus. mind. Yeah, that's what I feel like right now. But this is not the worst case of me losing my mind. Oh, no, 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 no. I've actually lost my mind through way worse. Here before I go down there. I'll take that. Beyond the Nile Valley. I'll read the rest. The pharaoh is long dead, his name meticulously stricken from all ancient writing, but that stage meant for blood and terror remains. The temple is said to be lightless, built to harbor all the haunters of the dark found in the very depths of our universe. Calling on the gods meant creating a bridge between our world and theirs. The terrible Aldebaran of Taurus, the Black Sun, was seen as the most important star in the night sky, because according to the Kitab al-Azif, it was said to be the home of that crawling chaos known as Yarlathotep. Through ancient mechanisms, it was said that the priests could open shafts channeling the light emitted by that strange stone called the Shining Trapezohedron, whatever. Several streams pulled together above the statue of that dark man would then be sent through space towards the Black Sun, a message to the gods. The gifts bestowed on the sender are completely undocumented, but often assumed to involve dark blood packs where souls are traded for meticulous miracles. So I could never ask for them. Huh. Anywho, let's get to that temple. Hi guys. Nice things. Yeah, just fly away. Okay, how am I supposed to get down? Might not with a rope, but... Anchor. Canopic jar. Get away from me. A lens crafted with unexpected precision and fitted with a telling hieroglyph. Okay. So I'm missing a lens here. There's a lens missing here too. Children of a Dark Sun. Yeah, on my face, your little corpse. Ooh. Hello. Yeah, just plant yourself on that wall. Oh, yes. Perfect. Alright, now we're making some progress here. That's what I like to say. Snake. Interesting. Star. Alright, I think there's three of these I gotta collect, and I already have two. So, gotta figure out where number three is at. So this has got to go on the other side. That's my guess. I think that was just only a portion of what I need to solve. Oh, right, there's that one. There we go. Okay, that's a little better. Uh-oh, more of these guys again. Yeah, burn. Burn, suckers. Get off. works. So now I gotta make my way back down to ground level. Christ! Alright, you guys are getting... Oh my god, you gotta be freaking kidding me. Wow. After all that... Eh, get out of here, you little twerps. Well, thankfully I don't have to start so far back. So that's good. Jesus Christ! Get off. Oh my god, are you freaking kidding me? I don't have time or patience to be doing the same thing again and again and again. I just don't. That's more like it. Oh. What the? Where's my melee weapon? I can use a quick drink. There we go. I lost my melee weapon? Are you kidding? Well, anyways, let's just head downstairs first. You gotta be kidding me! You have got to be freaking kidding me. Oh my god. I can't pick anything up? Are you... Oh my sweet gentle Jesus. How is this thing full when it's really not? I don't even have a melee weapon equipped. And yet it's telling me it's full? That's stupid. Well, I mean, there is another alternative. Just shoot the door. Because why not? A waste of ammo, but hey, at least we got in. There we go. Okay, that's better. All right. That's much better. Oop. Something's in there. But I find that kind of hard to believe that, That's a bug. Now she's gonna come to the conclusion and say, it's a bug. Oh, and a shortcut. Very nice. underworld. Oof. Alright. I can go back this way. Alright, now I gotta go all the way to the other side. All right. Oh, nice. Start burning some of these things up here, because, guys, why not? Aw. That's all right, now I gotta go all the way around once again. Oh, what fun. Oh, no, wait, now I remember. I never used it. That's why it's full. Oh, wait, hang on. I'm gonna burn these. Oh, come on. I can't burn them? That sucks. Well, when I had the other ones active, I probably should have burned those as well, but eh, whatever. All right. Yes, please do. Uh-oh. I was actually gonna say, if you want a quicker way down, just climb down, dude. It'd be a heck of a lot faster. More like it.
Acknowledge psychological trauma, break through barriers of self-deceit, temperamentic behavior. Contract.
Alright, you little buggers, get out of here. Hey, you better get out of here, you little twerps. Chapter 4. Now where am I?
Talisman.
It's around your neck. I worry, Detective.
Don't, I'm fine.
I worry that you're not much help on this case. At least you're a good distraction.
Well, that's gratitude.
Get your money. At this rate, I'm an absolute bargain.
Darkman's contract. Acknowledge psychological trauma, break through the barriers of self-deceit, temperamentic behavior. Medicine has failed me. Nothing can be done to dispel the Heartwood curse. Only the sacrificial dagger may release the despair from Jacob's eye, yet doing so will be the doom of Dorsetto. Let this curse of mine be a weapon for once. I accept your demands on crawling chaos. Build your prison around this godforsaken hospital. When evil has been starved, I will stay buried forever. Now it's night. I can't get back inside the attic, and yet there's something in there. Unless it's an Emily-only, mission. Locked. Well, back downstairs again.
Emily had reminded him about some strange deaths at the center, and Carmen wasn't.
preparations for St. John's.
You must have faith that Jeremy's pact with the Dark Man is a bluff. If we are lucky, our visitors will find him and prove it's all nonsense before the night falls. What is true is our attempt to call on him. Too many things have happened for this evening to be in vain. Think of Jeremy, even Perosi, whose circumstances are likely.
Like there's new items in the library. Let's go find out. Alright, I'm just reading it here. Lunacy in the Astart Artist Colony, a monograph by Yale Klein, printed in 1916 Lumina. In early 1909, the old Thurcetto plantation outside of New Orleans was turned into an artist colony. Three famous European artists rented the house and the surrounding land from the owner, the Ledoux family. The colony was chiefly run by Sebastian Cortez, who was playfully dubbed the captain by his collaborators, William Argus and Heinrich Cassel. The colony existed for 6 years until one day all 12 members disappeared without a trace. It is widely believed that their disappearance is connected to the disastrous hurricane that passed through on September 29, 1915, but nothing truly supports this claim. What is known is their frequent participation in New Orleans nightlife, their love for hosting parties, and their elaborate contributions to the Mardi Gras parades as the Pirates of Pontchartrain. Accounts of their lifestyle can be found in almost every gossip column. It can effectively be summed up as carefree and bohemian. In late June 1909, the name Estart first appeared in the newspapers. Cortez said the name came to him as he was painting. There was never any claim to knowing about the ancient Phoenician fertility goddess with the same name before his time. His fellow colonist Heinrich Cassel did know, because he later produced sculptures that showed clear references to ancient idols of the goddesses. Whatever. It's impossible to know for sure how this name suddenly made an appearance, but it is interesting because of Derceto's history. Even the name Derceto is the Greek name of a Syrian fertility goddess. In the case of naming the plantation, Derceto was certainly not an accident. We know that Eliah Pickford intended to build a temple for his cult, for he had distributed pamphlets 2 years prior to the purchase of the land advertising his intentions. His followers were estimated to be almost 100 men and women, mostly sailors, maroons, and Cajuns. When the plantation was built, to outsiders, Derceto registered as an ordinary slave plantation, which enabled Pickford and his flock to remain hidden for decades. The official story is that the cult lasted until 1862, when the Union Army came and burned down the plantation and scattered all who lived there. Following the Civil War, new people started to congregate in the ruins of Derceto to invent a new fertility goddess, the Shub-Niggurath. As much as Derceto is a particular name to have heard of, it's not entirely uncommon among the learned. Astart is equally known and could have been subconsciously chosen by well-read artists. Shub-Niggurath is, on the other hand, very uncommon. Almost impossible that anyone in Louisiana would have heard of that name. The name is referenced only in rare books like Colton, and the Necronomicon, and is believed to be a bastardization of Arabic words meaning pertaining to the Dark Young. The few paragraphs printed on the goddess who are so upsetting that no one in their right mind would want to build a religious resting on such qualities. Who would? The Shub-Niggurath cult was hard to get rid of, but it is believed that despite the police jailing and killing several cultists over the years, the main culprit in the cult's demise is the cult itself, which seems to line up with every instance of cult activity on Derceto's grounds. When Captain J.W. Norton of the Union Army arrived, he described the people at Derceto as malnourished and maniacal. As such as the Army tried to save them, they fought back with fervor, as if nothing was going to stop them from slowly destroying themselves. While the disappearance of the Astart Artist Colony remains a mystery, the recurring motif seems to suggest that their fate involved lunacy and a hunger for self-sacrifice to that fertility goddess with a thousand names. There it is. Alright. So I guess it's interesting to know, so I guess some of these items don't appear till later. But there's still more here. Like, what else could there be? unless I missed something during the day or earlier. I mean, heck if I know. I probably gotta go. Well, you know what? Wait a sec. I wonder if I can go through the kitchen again. Okay, apparently not. Disturb. Still need a key, though. Okay. So how am I going to get to Detective Gray's office then if I'm not going to be able to get into Detective Gray's office? Keep our secrets.
Mrs. Thompson, I understand that last week has been busy. Under these circumstances, I find it important to remind you that your sister's concerns are not a public matter, nor is it something that should upset you. Please continue your excellent work, and don't spend a thought on the death of Garosa, or, more importantly, the suicide of Cassandra Beauregard. They should mean nothing to you or the staff. I rely on your and trust that your close kinship with the Tabois siblings will keep Dorsetto's secrets in.
Flying Dutchman. What a terrible thing to recognize that your betterment was an illusion. That you are so infatuated by the virtue of struggling that despite all your hard work, you made no real efforts to ever become well. Or that the treatment becomes such an obsession that instead of letting your wounds heal over time, you tear at the flesh in the hope it will heal better and faster. If only it would bleed in the way you wanted. Do we ever become well? What do you think, Dr. Gray? Couldn't tell ya. Now I gotta go hunt down Jeremy and find another combination again. Once more. Mezzanine. Trust me.
Brother, I need you to trust me. This is the most important moment in our family's history. I know you have doubts and that the terrible Mama Lola told you lies. I would never betray you. I promise. Lie.
Sins take her away from this cursed place. I have destroyed that idiot of words. Locked it away in the attic and retreated to a place of hiding. Tell Emily I'm safe. Tell her all the lies you can think of to make her listen. Take her back to Norwich. Sincerely, Jeremy.
Huh, not exactly the combination of the safe I want.
Just something about tonight, so devil. I can feel Jeremy.
She'll come and turn the world inside out. Things will begin again.
That sounds strange.
You should come.
God damn it, Grace. Stay put for once.
Sandra's last page.
That the only room you found was the guest at room number 3. The room seemed to have been empty for so long. But that wasn't allowed to be true. The story needed to be different. To include something from the outside, he would bring the guest back to room 3 and show them what was in that safe. 9-1-3. But those were not the right. Combination for the safe in the clerk's office.
What did you expect from them? You created too much. There wasn't any room to breathe. Your rarefication rendered all possible worlds void. Worlds void. You took everything they could imagine and constrained it into something that you didn't even care about. Or maybe you did. Perhaps you cared the most of all. Maybe you tried to save them from themselves, and that is why you had to die. Yikes. Oh, that was from before. Well, that was a puzzle we solved earlier. One can only assume 913 is the safe combination. All right, now that I have the key, let's go inside the first floor hall. I think we're done up here for now. Let's open up this door first. What the? Oh, good lord. Him again. Later, dude. I'll be back later. Empty room.
The last guest in the empty room suffered from severe maladaption. I must write this down, because if I understand the condition sufficiently, it could make me deny this fact at a later date. And there is reason for me to think everything was predetermined, but broken. Upon accepting this worldview, some memories became unmanageable, and later, rejected. I do not know what this means. I cannot even remember the fate of the guest. I think they were simply misplaced one day and just like all documents pertaining to this guest, they have all been destroyed, or they never existed in the first place. Who wrote this? There has never been a guest in the empty room.
Wait, there's another puzzle here? Oh, it's on the other side. Alright. Never mind. Treasure.
This is when McCarthy is hitting my favorite gun.
Stairwell key. Okay. Now we're getting somewhere. Jeremy's treatment. I'm actually going to read this to you guys. Dearest Dr. Manzetti, I find myself in a losing battle with my patient. As I've disclosed in my previous letter, his delusions have him completely captured. It's bad enough that he is torturing himself with paranoia, but his madness turned out to be quite persuasive to others, effectively laying on the ground for mass delusion. I am writing to you in hope that you can give me some guidance. Beyond my ambition to avoid a devastating surgery on my patient, I have grown worried about my own defenses. The words of my patient are deranged, yet they often resonate with something primitive within me. I have tried photographing his brain with x-rays. It was surprisingly difficult to get good results. Dark blotches on the plates kept obstructing all details. My patient looked at the bad plates and cried out in terror, telling me the dark areas was the shadow of the worm eating him from inside. I cannot see anything out of the ordinary. I hope this is a sign that my mind is not as receptive to the madness as I had feared. After further inquiry, my patient described the shadows inside his mind as some kind of monstrosity that wants to undermine his sanctuary. This is clearly a reference to a place he calls Tarella, a sort of library or convent that works as a psychological haven. With this imaginary haven threatened by his Cathantian, whatever, he has now constructed another less pleasant hiding spot. Lately he has been bringing up a metaphor of a steamboat that has run aground, that he feels like he needs to start the engines in reverse. But he is afraid that the hole in the hull would cause the whole ship to sink. I've been watching him turn this metaphor into reality for the last week. He knows it's made up, but he is doubling down, trying to make it a real memory. I feel certain that this is my chance to break through the barriers of self-deceit. Alright, so our next up is the infirmary. Is there really another puzzle in this room? Or is it on the other side? No, this can't be. I mean, I solved this. I got the safe unlocked. Well, it matters little. What the? Oh, Jesus. This can't be real. Of course it's real, my friend. Well, that was unexpected. There's one more item in the clerk's office, and I don't have it. Maybe we'll be back later. Oh, I can open up the stairwell now. Nice. But you know what? I think this is just a good spot to save it right now. Alright, anyways, I think everything seems to be in order here. It was a bit of a rough start, but hey, at least we're making more progress here. But anyways, thank you to those who watched. I'll see you all next time.